Big work has been done in order to create infrastructure, setting up of necessary financing instruments, venture funds, state corporations, and creation of seed funds, and creating a special legal regulation which will support IP and technology transfer and other issues. And a number of new innovations have been introduced also for regulation of the whole economy in order to provide cooperation and setting up of joint business with the world leaders. And here, now in entirely new conditions, we are coming to new options and new possibilities to set up Indo-Russian collaboration in biopharma, using those, first of all, needs, secondly, demands, etc. But one should say that it's not easy, actually, to use even those obvious and open opportunities, open doors which are existing. And as a sample case, I will give just a cooperation of Russia with the European Union. It took about 10 years in order to establish efficient Russian-European cooperation in high-tech, also including life sciences. So this is major areas of cooperation, and life sciences are placed in first place. Here it's Russia-EU cooperation. And in life sciences, these five directions has been defined. Again, it's pharmaceutical and medical engineering. And you know this program FP7, which is major financial instrument from European Union. And among associated countries, Russia is number one today, isn't participating in European programs. But as I said, it took about more than 6 years in order to develop necessary infrastructure, communicating mechanisms, technological platforms, joint technological platforms, in order to allow to come together scientists and research people and business units from both Russia and EU in order to come with joint products and projects and to work together. But from the other side, in Russia also exist very big opportunities to provide financing for such joint projects. So just one figure for 2009, total budget for R&D in Russia in all areas, actually it's not only life science and biotech, it's more than 6.5 billion USD. And what is very important, about 700 million USD is devoted for the joint projects, cooperation projects with foreign countries. Today, in a very big extent, it's a cooperation with European countries, but at the same time, any other country from any other place, and first of all, I would consider here in this audience, India and other FABA countries could participate in such projects. So, we have everything basically in our hands. It's possible today because of necessity, because of availability of funds and resources, and also intellectual resources from both sides, from Russia, from India, to move together and to renew efficient collaboration how it was in past. Just mentioning two other major areas in biotech for cooperation, it's AgriBio, it's biotechnological plants, transgenic biopreparations for plants, biotechnology animals, biopreparation for animal health. Here again we could see very big complementarity between Indian research and activity which is going on and that one which is carried now in Russia. Even more, it is in case of industrial biotechnology. India is focusing primarily on enzymes. Now, if we are speaking about industrial biotechnology, while in Russia, enzyme industry is quite well developed, and now it is focusing mainly on bio-based chemicals, bioplastic, biopolymers, biofuels, and bioenergy, and this could be exactly areas for cooperation. As I said, in order to establish such efficient cooperation, it will require very serious efforts to establish necessary infrastructure. I think such events as BIA Asia Forum and others like Eurasia BIA, which we carried last year in Moscow with the participation of about 40 countries and many Asian countries as well, and also FABA participate on that. Technology Transfer Summit, which has been first time carried last year in Moscow, and now we are planning to carry similar events under the FABA umbrella in one of the FABA countries, and this would be defined exactly these days. So all these elements of setting up of cooperation. Besides that, it has been decided, and now a new project is going on between Russian Biotechnology Society and FABA. It's the establishing of special biotechnology network portal, Russia-Indian Biotech Network. It is expected that the final work of this biotech network would be done by March, April, and already this year, I think we'll have a unique first, professional network for biotechnologies, which would allow all these B2B meetings and all necessary cooperation, looking for technologies, looking for partners, looking for investments, etc., etc., to carry online regime, and covering it globally. First of all, it would be Russia-India cooperation, and it would be open for all other FABA countries as well. It's just some figures illustrating how this portal looks like. Just recently, Russia accepted a special program, strategy for development of biotechnology in Russian Federation up to 2020. And in this program, which also can be made available for everybody who would be interested, all major outlines made, what are those projects, what are those directions, and very big emphasis is made for international collaboration, and Russia-India collaboration could be one of them, the most important ones. And in order to finish my presentation, I'll just remind you that in December, President of Russian Federation, Mr. Dmitry Medvedev, visited India. And this is just some remarks in press which has been made. Russia remains one of India's most steadfast partners, despite of the fact that new geopolitical realities draw both countries closer to other countries like US and China. Over 50% of all bilateral trade between Russia and India involves innovation and technological products. Today, in majority, of course, it's weaponry. This defense issues. This is precisely what Russia tried and failed to achieve with China, with many other nations, and even with EU countries. Thank you very much, and I want to congratulate all of you with opening this extremely important and interesting event as FABA Forum, and I invite you all of you for cooperation.